We have also seen the positivity rate of these states before dengue seasons. I'll tell you that the weekly positivity rate in UP was only 0.24%. In Uttarakhand, it was 1.01%. In Punjab, it was 2%. Hello?
Slowly.
Figures. Acha figure. In UP, the positivity rate was 0.24%. In Uttarakhand, the positivity rate was 1.01%. In Punjab, it was 2.1%. In Manipur, it was 1.1%. And Goa, it was something around 13% because of the newer party by the outsider in that state. So these are the positivity weekly rates which we have seen and perused by all of us. And we have taken the opinion of medical experts, the union health secretary, and other secretaries as I discussed with you. We have appointed health nodal officers at the districts, state, and assembly constituency level and in all polling states. And in view of COVID concerns, polling time has been increased by 1 hour to all in all five states, and the time will be notified when the notification will be issued of those particular states. In view of emphasis on non-contact based campaign during pandemic conditions, Commission has decided to double the free equitable time allotted to the recognized political parties on Doordarshan and AER during these elections. It is expected that all stakeholders, namely political parties, candidates, campaigners, voters, and authorities engaged in the election process, shall be conscious of their prime duty towards public health, safety, and therefore shall abide by the general instructions and other norms of COVID-appropriate behavior as mandated by the respective authorities prescribed. Further, political parties and candidates are advised to conduct their campaign as much as possible through digital, virtual media platforms, mobile-based mode instead of physical mode, ensuring strict compliance of COVID safety norms. And keeping it in mind, the expenditure limit of the candidates have already been increased from 28 to 40 lakh. A detailed guidelines are being issued and which will be given to all of you regarding the COVID guidelines 2022 as to how the political parties, how the election officials, how the EVM persons will be dealt with and will be dealing with the COVID appropriate behavior. But the main point I would like to share with you, the Commission has decided that no roadshow, padyatra, cycle, bike vehicle rally and procession shall be allowed till 15th January 2022. Commission shall subsequently review the situation and issue further instructions accordingly. So up to 15th of January, because the situation is dynamic, it is not static, no roadshow, no padyatra, no cycle, bike or vehicle rally and any procession. Similarly, no physical rally of political parties or probable candidates or any other group related to election shall be allowed till 15th of January. Commission shall subsequently review the situation, considering the situation of the pandemic, and issue further instructions accordingly. So up to 15th of January, there is absolutely a moratorium of physical rally and physical road shows. Between 8 p.m. and 8 a.m., no rallies and public meetings. Similar like a campaign curfew that on any campaign day. That will continue. No nukkar sabhas will be allowed on public roads, roundabouts, or public streets or corners. Fifth, no victory procession after the counting shall be allowed, and not more than two persons shall be allowed to accompany the winning candidate or his or her authorized representative to receive the certificate of election from returning officers. So we are reducing the physical contact, physical availability, and we are saying that more and more virtual and virtual rallies, virtual campaign should be done. However, physical rallies during the campaign period, after considering the situation, which is very dynamic, and when permitted after the decision of the Commission, shall be conducted subject to adherence to COVID-19 guidelines. The maximum limit of persons allowed for indoor and outdoor rally meeting shall be as per existing directions of SDMAs. For these meetings, political parties shall distribute masks and sanitizers to persons attending and maintain COVID protocol at entry and exit point. Further rallies and meetings shall be allowed only in earmarked places and with prior permission of district administration. Door-to-door campaign, a maximum of 5 persons including candidates, excluding security personnel if any, shall be allowed to do door-to-door campaign. Each political party candidate shall have to furnish an undertaking in the application form under Suvidha that it shall abide by all the extant instructions, guidelines in this regard. So an undertaking will also be taken whenever any rally will be allowed. Later on, when we review the situation after 15th or something like that, only then again also these undertakings, COVID guidelines have to be strictly followed with each and every person who is involved in the campaign.